And I can see in all of you here, on the faces of every one of you, if I look and glare at the face of every one of you, I can see that there is love for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. Love cannot hide itself. You can see it, right? Don't you see it with young people who get engaged and propose to young girls before marriage is consummated? When they meet each other, they don't want to speak to their parents. They don't want to go on picnics. They don't want to go anywhere. All they want is just to speak to their beloveds. They want to meet their spouses. They just want to get with each other on phone or meet each other. They are in love before getting married. Love cannot hide itself. And when people are in real love, then people get lean. People get lean because you're busy-minded. The preoccupation of the mind takes toll on your body. Al-Ma'mun was very lean. The famous Abbasid Khalifa, son of Harun al-Rashid, was very lean. One of his wives, a slave girl serving him, inquired, why? He answered, وَقَائِلَةٍ لِمْعَرَتْكَ الْهُمُومُ وَأَمْرُكَ مُمْتَثَلٌ فِي الْأُمَمُ فَقُلْتُ ذَرِينِي عَلَى حَالَتِي فَإِنَّ الْهُمُومَ بِقَدْرِ الْهِمَمِ. Someone asks me, why do you have so much worries in your mind? His answer was, leave me in my state because worries come in conformity with ambitions. You're worried in as much as you're ambitious. You have no ambitions, you have no worries. Al-Mutanabbi put it in a clearer way. He says, وَالْهَمُّ يَخْتَرِمُ الْجَسِيمَ نَحَافَةً وَيُشِيبُ نَاصِيَةَ الصَّبِيِّ وَيُهْرِمُ. هَمْ, worries, the preoccupation of the mind, makes the big person lean and thin, and makes the young person's hair grow gray. It is because of what? Because of thinking a lot. Science supports this. The brain consumes 25% of the energy the whole body consumes. So if you are in love, the signs will appear on you. It will be very clear. You cannot hide it. What about being in love with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam? You claim that you love Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, and you want people to buy this without any proof, without any sign. Even the name of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is mentioned, and you don't change. The name of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is mentioned, and you don't send prayers upon him sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. The sunnah is presented to you, and you're indifferent, as it is irrelevant to you. It addresses another generation, some other people on another planet. There should be some signs. These signs are very important. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam spoke about the signs of the sweetness of Iman in a hadith agreed upon. The signs of the sweetness of Iman, ثَلَاثٌ مَنْ كُنَّ فِيهِ وَجَدَ حَلَاوَةَ الْإِيمَانِ, and made one of them to love Allah and His Messenger more than anything else. Three qualities. If you have them, you will taste the sweetness of Iman. Number one, to love your brother, but for the sake of Allah. Number two, that Allah and His Messenger are dearer to you, more beloved to you than anything else. Number three, that you dislike to become a non-believer or to return to a state of kufr for people who reverted to Islam as much as you dislike or fear to be thrown in fire. Three qualities, there are signs. You want the sweetness of Iman, then these are ways to get the sweetness of Iman. You claim to love Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, you have to present proofs and people have to see signs on you. And Imam Malik ibn Anas was very picky, very meticulous about the qualities of his teachers. He had one important principle after all other principles of knowledge and righteousness. He had one important principle. He examined his teachers. He observed them. When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's name is mentioned, how would they react? if they reacted in awe and adab and humbleness and yearning towards him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then he studied with them. There is a narration about one of his teachers, Ayyub al-Sikhtiyani, a great scholar of Al-Madinah, a great narrator of Hadith, one of At-Tabi'een. Ayyub al-Sikhtiyani, Imam Malik accompanied him and didn't take any of his Hadith till he observed him. When Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was mentioned, Ayyub al-Sikhtiyani used to shake and shiver when the name of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is mentioned. The Sahaba radiyallahu ta'ala anhum had the best example of the awe of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and attachment to him. And I really don't know how people live without yearning to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. To be honest, can you live without air? Can you live without air? Wallahi, shawq, yearning to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, love for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is more important to your soul than the air to your body. And I know some people, if Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is absent from them, Imam Abu al-Abbas al-Mursi said it, and I quoted this before, if Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is absent from me 1 second, I wouldn't consider myself a believer. Wallahi, if we are alive, if we have any pleasure in this life, it is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. If not our meeting with him, if not our vision of him, if not seeing him and his light sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it should be the shawq, the yearning for that. The yearning for that should be enough for you to live, to give you enough hopes for this life to spend on the face of the earth. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made it forbidden for anyone to wish to die, because he said, if you are a sinful person, you might get an opportunity to repent. If you are a righteous person, you get an opportunity to increase your good deeds. And if you have any reason to live on the face of the earth, it should be Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Wallahi, with every night I go to bed, I have shawq, I have hopes, I have wishes, I have anticipations, expectations that this night I'm going to see Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in my dream. I love to sleep because I can see Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in my dreams. Alhamdulillah, I don't want to speak about the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. I can speak, of course, about my relatives who are close to me. I can see my relatives, and you know how much you can enjoy seeing your relatives if you love them very much, your father, your teacher, some of your relatives. You know how much joyous this to the heart when you see them. So imagine seeing Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam in your dreams. Imagine going to bed with these hopes, with these ashwaq, that you miss Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and you want to see him. So you have to meet him in the best form, following his sunnah. You prepare yourself for meeting him. You're going to see him in your dream. You're going to meet him in your dream. So prepare yourself. Finish your dhikr. Finish your recitation of Al-Quran Al-Kareem. Pray a sunnah after Al-Fard. Make prayers upon him sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Go to bed. Prepare yourself. If you don't see him tonight, you're going to see him next night. If you don't see him tomorrow, you're going to see him after tomorrow. Live with this hope. It gives you enough reasons to live on the face of the earth. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam is more important to us than cold water when we are thirsty. And was dearer to the Sahaba radiyallahu ta'ala anhum, as Sayyidina Ali radiyallahu ta'ala an explained, than cold water when they were thirsty. Ala al-dhama. I'm talking about thirst that leads to death when people are traveling through the desert in hot weather and they are about to die. And then cold water is offered. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam is dearer to them. And people can afford this. People in love can afford hunger, thirst, exhaustion, tiredness, can forget pain for the sake of their beloveds. Animals yearn to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. A trunk of a tree, the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam used to stand and rely upon a trunk of a tree, a palm tree. When the pulpit was built for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he moved to stand up on the pulpit. The Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala all together heard the yearning, the noise of a trunk of a tree. And this hadith is mutawatir, narrated by many of the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum. There is no doubt about this event. We should spread the miracles of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. In Christianity, they talk about the miracles of Jesus, and all they have is few miracles, a couple of dozens of miracles. We have a couple of thousands of miracles of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Not a couple of dozens, a couple of thousands of miracles of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, and in detail much more than this. Within 23 years of his message sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, you could imagine how many miracles would happen every day. Every day miracles are happening. And we have in detail so many reports in the books of hadith, books such as Dala'il al-Nubuwa of Imam al-Bayhaqi, Dala'il al-Nubuwa of Imam Abu Nu'aym, and other books. One of the latest works on the miracles of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam is a book written by Imam al-Shaykh Yusuf al-Nabhani, a great lover of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a Palestinian scholar, died in Lebanon year 1350, al-Shaykh Yusuf al-Nabhani, authored over 100 books, most of them devoted to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. Such should the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's love do in our hearts and in our life to change it. You want to see the signs of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's love on your face, in your body, follow his sunnah. Make mention of him, repeat prayers upon him, be in awe of him when he is mentioned sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. Yearn to him, read about him, live his life, live his sunnah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. And then you will be given the opportunities to meet him, to see him, and to drink from his basin, and to meet him on the day of judgment in Al-Firdaus Al-A'la, inshaAllah, which is a wish of every one of us. Dear brothers and sisters, with that I end, because Isha time, I think, is in. I end my talk with the prayers, sincere prayers, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put us here in this masjid together, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to meet brothers and sisters on the day of judgment in something similar to this. And we would remember our previous gatherings here in Keithley, inshallah. I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward every one of you for coming here, for this love you have for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, for your adab in the house of Allah, and in listening to this humble servant in front of you with the humble rewards he ever rewarded any lover of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.